Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this exercise, we are going to compare the sense of rotation of two sprocket wheels. Compare the angular speeds of the two wheels. Determine the expression of the angular speed of each wheel. Calculate the number of rotations performed by wheel D2 when wheel D1 performs 4 rotations. Calculate the tangential and the normal or radial accelerations of point A on wheel D1 at time 1.59 seconds.
Two sprocket wheels D1 and D2 are connected by a roller chain. The radius of D1 is R1 equals 20 cm and the radius of D2 is R2 equals 5 cm. A and B are two points on the circumference of D1 and D2 respectively. These two points have the same speed, which is equal to 4t, v in meters per second and t in seconds. The disk D1 rotates in the positive sense, or it rotates in the counterclockwise. Number 1. Compare the sense of rotation of the two wheels. Observe this simulation. As the first disc rotates in the counterclockwise, then the second disc also rotates in the counterclockwise. So the two wheels rotate in the same sense. Number 2. Give the values of the distances traveled by A and C when B travels 2 cm, where C is a point on the roller chain. Look at this figure. As B travels a distance x, then C travels the same distance x since the roller chain is an extensible, and also A travels the same distance x. Then as B travels a distance of 2 cm, then A and C travel the same distance, which is 2 cm.
Let's move to part 3. What is the value of the radial acceleration at point C? The normal acceleration or the radial acceleration is given by this expression v squared over r. Point C lies on a straight path. At any point on a straight path, the radius of curvature goes to infinity. Then, the normal acceleration at point C is zero. Let's move to part 4. Without calculation, compare the angular speeds of the two wheels. The angular speed of wheel D1 is given by this expression, theta 1 prime equals VA over R1. And the angular speed of wheel D2 is theta 2 prime, which is equal to VB over R2. Now, examine the two equations. VA equals VB. R1 is greater than R2, then theta 1 prime is less than theta 2 prime.
Watch this animation to prove that theta 1 prime is less than theta 2 prime. Look at these two points. As the disk D1 performs an angle less than pi radians, then the second disk or disk D2 performs an angle of 2 pi radians. That means theta 1 prime is less than theta 2 prime. Now observe the rotation of each disk. We can conclude that the number of rotations performed by disk D2 is greater than that performed by disk D1 because theta 1 prime is less than theta 2 prime. Number 5. Determine the expression of the angular speed of each wheel. The angular speed of D1 is denoted by theta prime 1, which is equal to VA over R1. R1 equals 20 cm, which is equal to 0.2 meters. VA equals 4t. Then theta prime 1 equals 20t in SI units. The angular speed of D2 is denoted by theta prime 2, which is equal to VB over R2. R2 equals 5 cm, which is equal to 0.05 meters, and VB equals 4t. Then theta prime 2 equals 80t in SI units.
Yes, please. This is important.
Let's move to part 6. Determine the number of rotations performed by D2 when D1 performs 4 rotations. When D1 completes one rotation, it rotates through an angle of 2 pi radians. When it completes 4 rotations, it rotates through an angle which is equal to 4 times 2 pi, which is equal to 8 pi radians. Now we want to calculate the time needed by D1 to move through an angle of 8 pi radians, and then we will calculate how many rotations would disk D2 or wheel D2 perform during this time. So let's start by calculating the angular acceleration of D1. The angular acceleration of D1 is the time derivative of its angular velocity. The time derivative of 20 t with respect to time is 20. Then theta 1 double prime equals 20 radians per second squared. Each point on the periphery of wheel D1 is in circular motion with constant angular acceleration. Then these are the 3 basic equations of this motion. Which equation would we choose to calculate the time needed by D1 to perform 4 rotations or to move through an angle of 8 pi radians? Because we want to calculate the time, so we cannot use this equation. And because the angular velocity at the time t is not given, so we cannot use this equation, then we will use the second equation. Take theta 0 to the left side of the equation. You will get theta minus theta 0, which is delta theta. So delta theta equals 1/2 theta w prime t squared plus theta 0 prime t. Replace delta theta by 8 pi radians. Theta w prime by 20 radians per second squared. Therefore, t equals 1.59 seconds. This is the time needed by wheel D1 to perform 4 rotations.
Now, to calculate the number of rotations performed by D2, we have to calculate the angle performed by D2 during the time 1.59 seconds. Since theta 2w prime is constant, then we can use this relation. The angle performed by D2 is given by 1/2 theta w prime t squared plus theta prime 0 t. Then replace theta w prime by 80, replace t by 1.59, and theta prime 0 by 0. Therefore, the angle performed by D2 during the time 1.59 seconds is 32 pi radians. But the number of rotations performed by D2 is given by this relation and equals the absolute value of delta theta 2 over 2 pi. The absolute value of delta theta 2 equals 32 pi, then n equals 16 rotations. But n can be calculated using another method. Each rotation corresponds to 2 pi radians. So if we have 32 pi radians, it corresponds to n rotations. Then n equals 1 times 32 pi over 2 pi, which is equal to 16 rotations.
Let's move to part 7. Determine the magnitudes of the tangential and the normal accelerations of point A on wheel D1 at time 1.59 seconds. Let's start with the tangential acceleration. It is equal to r times theta w prime. The radius of wheel D1 is 20 centimeters, which is equal to 0.2 meters, and theta w prime equals 20 radians per second squared. Therefore, the magnitude of the tangential acceleration at time 1.59 seconds is 4 meters per second squared. Before calculating the magnitude of the normal acceleration, let's calculate the speed of point A at this instant. Replace t by 1.59 seconds in the expression of v. Then, the speed at this instant equals 6.36 meters per second. Now, let's calculate the normal acceleration. It is equal to v squared over r. The speed at this instant is 6.36 meters per second, and the radius is 0.2 meters. Therefore, the magnitude of the normal acceleration at time 1.59 seconds is 202 meters per second squared.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.